The first ancient Britons had black skin, dark curly hair and blue eyes, according to DNA tests. The extraordinary findings were made by cutting-edge genetic tests, and facial reconstruction techniques carried out for the first time on the bones of Cheddar Man who died 10,000 years ago. The bones, found in Somerset's Cheddar Gorge, are the oldest near-complete human skeleton ever found in Britain, and scientists said they were surprised to discover that the earliest Briton would be considered black if he lived today. The research suggests the first inhabitants of the British Isles developed white skin later on than previously thought. Experts also revealed that Cheddar Man is directly related to 1 in 10 people living in the UK today. The Natural History Museum and Channel 4 unveiled a reconstruction of the ancient human yesterday, which was made for a documentary, The First Brit: Secrets of the 10,000-Year-Old Man. Cheddar Man's bones caused a sensation when they were unearthed in Cheddar Gorge, Somerset in 1903. For more than 100 years, scientists have tried to reveal Cheddar Man's story, posing theories as to what he looked like, where he came from and what he can tell us about our earliest ancestors. Only now, with cutting-edge DNA and facial reconstruction techniques, can we see for the first time the face of this 10,000-year-old man, and ask how 300 generations later he relates to us today. Dr. Tom Booth, a scientist from the museum, said that the findings, that there was a 76% chance that Cheddar Man was dark to black, was extraordinary. He said in the documentary, "If a human with that color skin wandered around now, we'd call him black, and a lot darker than we'd expect for Europe as well." Dr. Rick Schulting, an archaeology professor at Oxford University, said, "It may be that we may have to rethink some of our notions of what it is to be British, what we expect a Briton to look like at this time." A previous reconstruction of Cheddar Man, made by the University of Manchester before DNA tests were available, depicted him with white skin. Britain in the Mesolithic era, the Middle Stone Age around 8000 BC, was a very different place from today. An ice age had just finished and the land had become green again. Herds of aurochs, huge, wild cattle, and red deer roamed the land. The total human population in Britain was then just 12,000. Tests on the DNA of modern Britons reveal we have around 10% of our DNA in common with Cheddar Man and his tribe. Close genetic matches to Cheddar Man have been found in remains in Western Europe at sites including Spain, Hungary and Luxembourg. Scientists say that Cheddar Man's ancestors arrived in Britain via the Middle East, after coming out of Africa. Professor Ian Barnes, research leader at the Natural History Museum, said at a screening of the documentary, "Not just dark skin and blue eyes, because you can get that combination, but also the face shape. So all of this combines together and make him just not the same as people you see around today." Professor Barnes added that although this was just one individual, he said, "At the moment I'd suggest this is a good model for what the rest of Britain looked like." They scanned the skull and a 3D model was produced by Palo artists Alphonse and Adrie Kaes, Dutch identical twins who make lifelike reconstructions of extinct mammals and early humans. The brothers, who have created reconstructions for museums around the world and usually create models of Neanderthals, spent 3 months creating Cheddar Man. Cheddar Man is thought to have had a relatively good diet, and his bones suggest that he would be much stronger than most people today. Professor Mark Thomas said one theory is that white skin developed in Britain and Western Europe after our ancestors switched to farming and began to eat less meat. This meant that instead of getting a lot of vitamin D from liver and fish, they needed to get more from sunlight, which meant they needed fairer skin.